亲爱的欧克兰华人福音教会弟兄姐妹们，大家早上好。
Good morning, brothers and sisters at the OCCC.
今天是国庆节的主日，我很荣幸在这边可以分享福音的信息。
麦克开一下。
I saw it either. Okay, is that open?
All the way here.
Yeah. Okay. 今天是国庆节的主日，我很荣幸在这里主日分享信息。
I'm very pleased to share the God's word on the 4th of July.
今天我想跟各位分享的主题是疫情后的智慧。
The topic would be the wisdom post and pandemic.
我选的经文是传道书七章一到十三节。
The passage I've choose is in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, or 1 to 13.
我希望跟你分享我在几年前研读这本书的心得，用今天的机会来分享。
Today I want to share you what I've received from this book a couple of years ago.
因为我平常是用释经讲道，所以我不会另外做 PowerPoint.
I'm not, because usually when I preach, I just explain the verses, so I'm not going to use PowerPoint.
所以我会跟着经文，通常是两节经文一段，解释了它的意思、思想、它的应用。
So I will pick every two verses. I'm going to start it and think about the application.
我们先来看传道书第七章。
Let's take a look at chapter 7.
传道书在很多人的印象中是一个很负面、消极的书。
The book of Ecclesiastes is for many people is a very passive, very sad book.
其实它在旧约圣经中属于智慧书。
It belongs to the book of wisdom in the Old Testament.
在圣经里面有两种智慧。
There are two kinds of wisdom in the Bible.
第一种是站在君王面前的智慧。
One wisdom is the wisdom standing in front of kings.
好像箴言是用来训练皇宫里的年轻人怎么样应对进退。
It's like the proverbs, they are training the youngsters in the palace to teach them how to go in and go back and forth.
然后在历史书里面常常提到君王身边有智慧人。
In the book of history, it always mentioned that there are wise men.Beside those kings,
然后也有智慧的妇女来到君王面前，用智慧话跟君王对谈。
And those wise women, they came to the kings and talked with kings with wisdom words.
那在箴言这种智慧里面，他强调先敬畏耶和华，因为耶和华是所有权力最高的源头。所以你要跟君王说话之前，你要先懂得敬畏那位最高的君王。
In the book of Proverbs, it teaches us how to fear the Lord, because all the authority, all the goodness are from our Lord. So before you talk to the kings, you have to learn how to fear the God.
所以当你敬畏耶和华的时候，你来到一位领导者的面前，你可以用一个很从容的态度跟他讲什么是轻重缓急，什么是大是大非。
With this kind of fearing heart, fearing in your heart, when you come to the leaders,You can explain what is more important, which is the strategy, according to the Lord.
因为你的心里面装着神的律法。
Because God's law is in your heart.
那旧约圣经有第二种智慧。
There are second wisdom in the Old Testament.
是查看神作为的智慧。
This is the wisdom that you can consider God's deed.
就像传道书或是约伯记里的智慧。
It's like a book of Job or the book of Ecclesiastes.
那当一个有智慧的人查看神在世间的作为的时候
，When a wise man consider what God has done in this world，
他的第一个印象是上帝的作为不受到人间的条条框框所约束。
The first impression that God's deeds is not refrained from any rules among the world，
也就是说，人没有办法去猜透上帝的作为。
In other words， human beings cannot comprehend。Cannot know completely God's plan and His deed.
常常上帝做的事情和我们认为最好的安排是不一样的。
Many times what God has done is different from what we consider is the best.
那像传道书这样的智慧就思考说，那我如何在这个世界上安身立命呢？
In the book of Ecclesiastes, it teaches us how to deal with this world.
所以当他观察神在这个世界的作为的时候， 他发现了一个普遍的事实。
When the author considered what God has done, he found a general discovery.
在传道书第七章的第二节。
In the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 2,
他说因为死是众人的结局，活人也必将这事放在心上。
It says it is because death is the destiny of every man, so the living should take this to heart.
我相信整个传道书的神学是围绕这一句话开展出来。
I believe all the theology of this book is around this concept.
就是如果你明白死亡是众人的结局的话，所有这世界上面的优先次序突然间都不重要了。
If you understand that death is a destiny of all men, you will realize that the orders or everything in this world is not important anymore.
不管你是富裕的人还是贫穷的人，你是有权势的人还是卑贱的人，不管你是男人还是女人，你是智慧人还是愚昧人，在死亡的面前是完全平等的。
Whether you are the wise man or the fool,You are the powerful, or you are the humble man, or you are rich, or you are poor. In front, when you face the death, everyone is equal.
所以第一节说，名誉强如美好的膏油。
So it is said that a good name is better than a fine perfume.
膏油是给贵重的人用的。
A perfume is used for those noblemen.
美好的膏油是给特别贵重的人用的。
A good perfume or fine perfume is for, used for those who particularly high-ranked noblemen.
如果你一生坚持做对了一件事情，你就有了一个美名。这个名誉比那个美好的膏油还要贵重。
If you persistently doing one good thing, you will get a good name.Which is better than the pure perfume.
但是即便这样，你死的那日子还是强过你活的日子。
Even this, okay, the day of your death is better than the day of living.
因为来到死亡的面前，你的美名跟那些没有美名的人也是一样的。
Because in front of death, you with a good name is the same.As those without a good name.
这是智慧人查看神的作为得到的第一个结论。
This is the first conclusion when these wise men consider God's word.
就是如果死亡是众人的结局的话，
If death is the destiny of all men,
当你死的那一天，这个世界就往前走，他们不会纪念你，他们只能继续的往前走。
The world moves forward on the day when you die.They are not going to remember it.
换言之，这是个活人向前走的世界。
In other words, this world is the world that the living person move forward.
我们回想一下过去一年半在疫情中间发生了哪些重大的变化。
Let's reflect what really important things happened in the past 1.5 years.
疫情发生的时候，神带走了，神从这世上带走了很多人。
When it started, God.Took many people away from this world.
最早第一批离开的人，他们在中国的武汉。
The first batch of those people who died is in the city of Wuhan in China.
一年半之后，谁还记得武汉呢？
After 1.5 years, who remember Wuhan?
谁记得那些失去亲人的还在地上的这些家人呢？
Who remember those who have lost their families?
今天武汉已经开放观光了。
Nowadays, Wuhan is open for tourists.
可能比中国其他地方都更好。
Probably it's even better than the other place in China.
歌舞升平。
They have feast there. They have dance there. They have sing there. They have songs there.
你知道为什么吗？
Do you know why?
整个国家希望我们一起忘记武汉曾经有很多人离开。
The whole country wants us to forget that there are many people died in Wuhan.
那些家里面有人过世的，我们希望再也不要听到他们的声音。
For we no longer want to hear from those families who lost their relatives. Of,
朴树有首歌叫《平凡之路》，对不对？
There was a song called "Ordinary Way."
有很多人失败了。
Many people failed.
有很多人生病了。
Many people got sick.
有很多人离开了。
Many people left.
有很多人绝望了。
Many people got desperate.
但是他们的故事，你真的在听吗？
But do you still listening to their story?
在传道书第三章第七章第三到第四节这样说。
In the books of Ecclesiastes, chapter 7, verse 3 and 4, it says,
忧愁强如喜笑，因为面带愁容，终必使心喜乐。
Sorrow is better than laughter, because a sad face is good for the heart.
智慧人的心在遭丧之家，愚昧人的心在快乐之家。
The heart of the wise is in the house of mourning, but the heart of fools is in the house of pleasures.
你知道为什么有智慧的人总是面带愁容吗？
Do you know all these sad men? They always look sad. Wise men, they always look sad.
因为你一旦直视真相，研究问题，你就觉得很烦恼。
Because you are puzzled, you when you look into the question, when you try to find the truth.
可是，如果你不但看见了问题，你还想去解决它，你把责任放在自己身上。
Furthermore, if you have the question and you put the burden of solving this problem on yourself,
那你心里面想着你有一天还是会喜乐的。
And you still have the hope that someday you will rejoice.
你现在面带愁容，因为你在处理问题。
You are frustrated because you're handling with this problem.
等到问题解决了，你就笑了。
When you finish this problem, when you solve this problem, you will rejoice.
所以智慧的人现在愁苦，后来笑。
So those wise men, they are frustrated, they are sad nowadays, but they will rejoice in the future.
愚昧的人现在笑，后来哭。
But those fools, they laugh nowadays, but they're going to cry in the future.
回头看看美国的社会怎么样处理疫情。
Let's reflect back how Americans deal with this pandemic.
我是非常崇尚美国的民主、自由和宪政的。
I really admire the Americans' democracy here.
我也非常欣赏美国创建时期很多基督教信仰的影响。
I also admire those influence of the founding fathers when they established this country.
我在服侍中国大陆的年轻人、知识分子，有时候想他们有一天会不会学习到这种美式的宪政精神。
When I serve those in young people in China, I'm wondering.Probably someday they will learn this kind of politics in the United States.
可是说实在话，过去一年半，我对美国社会的这个光景是失望透顶。
But to tell the truth, I was very disappointed at the situation in the past 1.5 years.
因为美国人他们要自由，可是他们不明白自由的真谛。
For those Americans, they really want the freedom, but they don't know the true meaning of freedom.
美国人说自由的时候，是指政府不干预人民生活的自由，叫 liberty.
When they talk about freedom, they refer to the liberty that the government wouldn't interfere the life of people.
意思说老百姓有问题，老百姓自己解决。
In other words, if people have the problem, they're going to solve them by self, solve those problems by themselves.
所以美国人要愿意独立承担责任，愿意去争，然后输了愿意认输。
So they are very independent. They want to carry the burden. They want to fight, and they admit the failure when they lose.
我们在美国土地上抚养我们的第二代，也希望他们有一点独立精神，对不对？
So when we want our second generation to be more independent when we raise them in this land.
可是美国人有一个坏处，当他们得到这个自由的时候，他们把它等同于放纵享乐。
But there's a bad thing regarding this. When they receive this kind of freedom, they think they took it as a privilege to chase for those kind of lustful things.
基本上活着就是为了赚钱，赚钱就是为了享乐。如果死了没有关系，如果我活着没有自由，那我宁愿死了。
So when I live, I just want to make money so that I can enjoy. If I don't have the freedom, I would rather die.
所以疫情来的时候，病传染得很快，大家需要立刻约束自己，免得疾病传得更快的时候，美国人不作为的。
So when this during the in the beginning of a pandemic, because the fast spread of the virus, Americans need to refrain to restrict themselves from.Gathering, but they are not doing anything.
美国人不太在乎有多少人死了，他们比较在乎医疗系统是不是能够承受得住。
They don't care how many people got infected or how many people died. They really care if the medical system can handle that.
所以用一句话就是美式的自由叫做不自由无宁死。
So in summary, Americans' freedom is like I would rather die without freedom.
反过来想想，中国人就爱惜生命的多，对不对？
On the other hand, we Chinese cherish our life much more than Americans.
只要能够长命百岁，政府把我的自由拿走多少都无所谓。
If I live long enough, I don't care how much freedom the government took away from us.
我没有什么评论，这是文化差异。
I don't have any comments on this. It's just a different culture.
在第五节说，听智慧人的责备，强如听愚昧人的歌唱。
In verse 5, it is better to heed a wise man's rebuke than to listen to the song of fools.
愚昧人的笑声好像锅下烧荆棘的爆声，这也是虚空。
Like the crackling of thorn under the pot, so is the laughter of fools. These two is meaningless.
你们家有没有大铁锅可以炒中国菜的？
Do you have a pot that you can cook Chinese food at home?
你东西下锅的时候，好听的声音是那个油下去，那个肉下去，然后滋滋的响。
The most beautiful sound you have is just you pouring the pork into your hot pot.
然后你把葱放下去了，就爆香出来，整个屋子都是香气。
And you put a green onion in there, and it smells so good.
然后发了水以后煮一煮，听到咕噜咕噜咕噜的声音，对不对
？And you after you pour water in, when the boys you heard this song.
他说愚昧人的笑声好像你把一些有纤维很高的东西放在锅里烧干了烧焦了爆裂了啪啦啪啦啪啦啪啦啪整个屋子都是焦味的那种感觉
So those are the songs of the laughter of those fools is like you put those kind of thorns or fibers in the pot and when they got burned theyMake those kind of noise and the smell.
所以这两节其实就是智慧人在嘲笑愚昧人。
These two verses basically are the wise men they mock those fools.
这句话本身就是智慧人对愚昧人的责备。
This is the verse itself is a rebuke from the wise men to those fools.
意思说世界上有很多坏事发生，能不能不要再笑了？
It means that there are so many bad things happening in the world. Stop laughing.
你知道疫情来的时候我们就封关了吗
God, we closed the border when the pandemic happened.
那封关的时候除了生活的基本需要就不要出门了吗
And basically we are on the kind of curfew that you cannot go out unless you have to do some necessary thing.
那我是一个很内向的人大家封关的时候我特别喜乐
I'm the kind of man being more like an inside man, so I kind of rejoice, I like it when nobody is kind of communicating.
所有人都跟我一起关在家里，然后我上网要找谁都可以找到。
So everybody is at home, so if I want to look for somebody online, definitely I can find them.
那我太太就很辛苦，因为她是一个外向的人。
But my wife wants to go out.
我太太一天要出门三次，不然是很难受的。
She would be very upset if she cannot go out three times a day.
所以她在屋里面走来走去，什么时候可以出门啊？可是我就很舒服的在家里面。
So she was wondering in the house when I can go out, but I was enjoying this kind of a situation.
那些人封关了，在家里面做什么呢
？So what did the people do? Those people do at home when they cannot go outside?
我们封关的时候，大部分时间拿去滑手机了。
We spend most of our time. On the cell phone.
我们在手机上又去滑了什么呢
？What do we see on the cell phone?
魔术
，magic.
TikTok. 脱口秀
，talk shows.
娱乐性的新闻有没有
？And all those kind of news.
你可不可以不要再笑了
？Stop laughing.
这世界发生很多事情。
There are many things happening in this world.
你关在家里面就一直看这些东西。
You are just looking at this kind of news at home.
我们疫情封关的时候，我们在线上做了很多青年的施工。
We did a lot of reach out activity for the youth online.
我们的施工比没有封关前成长了一倍。
Actually, the people we have reached out doubled the number before the pandemic.
我们还增加了两位全职传道人。
We also have two full-time missionaries.
我们第一个先去赈灾。
We went to the
help those who
and we are.Getting funds, and then we're connecting masks.
支持医疗人员
and we send all the medical personnel.
支持老人院
help those elder homes.
疫情中，我们的年轻人很忙啊
And we young people are very busy during the pandemic.
然后我们年轻人担心时间会混乱呢
We are afraid that we are confused about the time.
我们早上约好七点钟一起线上晨更
We are praying in the morning at 7.
后来就出现了美东青年线上晨更跟美西青年线上晨更。
So we have this prayer meeting in the east time and the west time.
如果你在美东七点钟呢还没有起来，十点钟还可以参加美西的。
So if you are in the east time, you know, at 7 o'clock, you can pray, but you can join the prayer meeting in the west coast at 10.
我们不能出去外展工作的时候就沉潜好好做培训。
So if we cannot go outside to preach the gospel, but we can stay.And train our coworkers.
我们过去一年中做了很多的圣经辅导、归纳法研经，还有公共神学的培训。
So we have carried out many trainings in the Bible study and then in the public relationship.
神既然不让我们出门，我们关上门就做平常做不了的事情。
Since God closed the door, so we just stay at home and do what we cannot do before the pandemic.
疫情中还发生了另外一种变化。
There's another change during the pandemic.
就是政治环境非常不稳定
，and the political situation is very unstable.
先是美中关系很紧张
，and there was a tension between China and the United States.
然后欧洲的风向就一直在转
，and the Europe is taking different positions.
然后美国在大选
，and there's a big presidential selection.
然后印度的内政也不稳。
And also, there's instability in India.
然后缅甸有军事政变。
And there's a coup in the Myanmar.
然后香港通过了国安法。
And there's a kind of a law passed in the Hong Kong.
大家一面戴着口罩，一面在适应政治环境的改变。
In mask, we adapted to the change of the political situation.
在第七节说，勒索使智慧人变为愚妄。
In the verse 7, extortion turns a wise man into a fool.
贿赂能败坏人的慧心。
And a bribe corrupts the heart.
你知道什么叫政治吗？
Do you know what a politics is?
政治是管理权力的艺术。
Politics is the art of administer the power.
如果你坏一点，就说政治是管理权力的技术。
Or the skill of manipulating power.
那政治环境变化的时候，人们就要决定听谁的。
During this kind of a political situation, people has to choose who to listen to.
那有智慧的人面对政治环境变化的时候，是有可能变得很笨的。
Wise men, when they're facing the change of the political situation, they can be a fool.
是什么时候那些很有智慧的人会做出很蠢的决定呢
？When did this kind of wise man made a foolish choice？
这边讲到两种情况
，two situations。
第一种叫勒索，第二种叫贿赂。
One is extortion, the other one is bribe。
就是如果你不照我的，我就要伤害你，这叫勒索。
What is extortion? It says it's threat that if you don't do according to my will, I will hurt you.
如果你照我的，我就给你好处，这叫贿赂。
Bribe is that you do whatever I want you to do, I'll give you good things.
智慧人变成愚昧，因为他们受不了勒索和贿赂。
When wise men, if they cannot resist extortion and pride, they turn into fool.
但那些真的有智慧的人，他们可以看懂一件事，使他们可以忍耐。
But for those truly wise men, they just know one thing, so they can persistent.
所以第八节说，事情的终局强如事情的起头。
That's why verses 8 said the end of a matter is better than its beginning.
看眼前的人容易被勒索，也容易被贿赂。
Those people who just care about what's in front of us, they can be easily extorted or bribed.
看终点的人不容易被勒索，也不容易被贿赂。
But those people who look at the end of this road, it is not easy for them to be extorted or bribed.
因为莎士比亚有一句话说：“谁笑到最后，谁笑得最好嘛。”
Is that Shakespeare says, I don't know if it's true. Who loved the at the end, we love the best.
It's a really good translator. 就是当我们明白在神所管理的世界里，什么东西会存到最后的时候，我们不会轻易放弃的。
When we realize that what will last to the end of this world, we wouldn't give up that easily.
但是当我们被眼前的东西捆绑的时候，我们很容易被别人影响。
But if we are bounded by things around us in front of us, we will be influenced easily by other people.
换言之，真正有智慧的人把他的生命安托在那些永恒的与信仰有关的事情上面。
In other words, if a wise man put his life to the eternity, to those truths.
什么时候一个国家、一个社会或一个教会里面有智慧、有见识的人不再出谋划策的时候，是这个群体的悲哀啊。
It's going to be a sad situation when the wise men in the government or at a church fail to give advice to this government.
我们家要做决定，你希望我们凡事听爸爸妈妈的话，还是爸爸妈妈凡事做智慧的决定？
In a family, when we make a decision, would you rather just listen to your daddy and mom, or you want your daddy and mom make wise decisions?
这两个最好是同时存在，我又有权力，我又有智慧，我又可以专注在永恒的事上。
The ideal case is that I have the power, I have the wisdom, and I can focus on the internal things.
但是当权力的关系改变的时候，有了勒索，有了贿赂，智慧人就不说话了，很多智慧人就放弃了，以至于大家都一直往一个愚昧的方向走去。
Unfortunately, many wise men, they gave up, they stopped talking when they are trapped in this kind of political turmoil and everybody is marching towards the foolish.
更不要说还有一大群人，他们其实从来没有从权力中间得到任何好处，他们也跟着一起摇旗呐喊，跟着主流的论述，然后一起跟风的喊话，其实他们得不到任何的好处，他们还是这样做了。
And a large group of people, those crowds, they never receive any benefit from this kind of government. So when they have followed this propaganda, they just follow them, although they couldn't receive anything out of it.
第九节说，你不要心里急躁恼怒，因为恼怒存在愚昧人的怀中。
In verse 9, it says, do not be quickly provoked in your spirit, for angerresides in the lap of fools.
不要说先前的日子强过如今的日子是什么缘故呢？你这样问不是出于智慧。
Do not say why were the older days better than this, for it is not wise to ask such questions.
如果你是一个智慧的人，你定睛在终局。
If you are a wise man, you put your eyes focusing on the eternity.
终局你已经知道了，刚才前面讲了终局是什么。
If you know the end, what end we just talked about?
死是众人的终局。
The death is the destiny of every man.
我们所有人都要向上帝交账的。
Every one of us has to account for God.
全人类都活在神死亡的咒诅的威胁之下。
All the human beings live on the curse of death from God.
我们有谁可以站在上帝的审判台前不战惊的呢？
Who can stand in front of the judgment seat without fearing?
因此我们更加的珍惜那永生的恩典，是借着他儿子耶稣白白赐给我们的。
So we cherish more the grace of eternal life from Jesus Christ.
所以说神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们，叫一切信他的不至灭亡，反得永生。
So God so loved the world, he gave his begotten only son, so that whoever believes him not perish, but have eternal life.
如果你定睛在那个终局的话，你现在看到的事情，你不要心里面恼怒。
If you focus on that end, you wouldn't get angry at what's happening now.
其实这一切坏事过去都发生过了。
Because all these bad things has happened before.
瘟疫，以前有更严重的。
Plagues, there were even worse plagues before.
然后美国的社会冲突很紧张，有没有
？The conflict in the society.
哎呀，你去看韩战跟越战那个时候，美国更严重了。
Just look at what happened during the Vietnam War or the Korean War. The split was even worse.
现在两个总统，现在川普跟拜登都还好好活着，你知道我意思吗
？So both Trump and Biden are still alive. Do you know what I mean?
现在的社会比以前还是舒服很多的。
What we have nowadays is better than before.
中国遭遇的事情很多啊。
In China, you haven't heard the worst things before.
所以传道书说，你日光之下没有新鲜事，什么坏事都发生过了，你怎么能指着一件事情说，哦，这件事是新的？殊不知，在你之前的世代早就有了，将来世代还要再有，他们也不知道。
So in the book of Ecclesiastes, it says, there's nothing new under the sun. What happened right now happened before. You don't know, it's just repeat again and again.
所以总统大选的时候，不管你选谁啊，
No matter who you select during the presidential election,
你讨厌的另外一个人当选都不是世界末日。
The one you don't like took the power, it's not the end of the world.
好事里面都是带着一些坏事的。
There's some bad things in the good things.
坏事里面也带着一些好事的。
And also bad, good things are buried in the bad things.
那你就认真的，反正坏事来了，我认真的研究处理它，对不对？
If something bad happens, I'll just study it and handle it.
然后现在不管谁当选了，我就面带愁容。换一个人当选，我也面带愁容。
I just have this sad face, you know, during the Biden's reign or whoever came into power.
然后负起责任去处理它，等到解决了，我就笑了。
I just took my responsibility to handle the situation, and when the problem solved, I rejoiced.
而且我深知在这个世上，不管我多成功，面对死亡那个高墙的时候，我一样要面对上帝。所有人都是一样的。
I also realize that no matter how successful I am in this world, when I face the death, everybody is the same.
这个叫做查看神作为的智慧。
This is the wisdom considering God's word and God's deed.
十一节说，智慧和产业并好，而且见天日的人得智慧更有益。
In verse 11, wisdom like an inheritance is a good thing and benefits those who see the sun.
我很喜欢这个比喻，把智慧比喻成产业。
I like this kind of
就是
verses to put wisdom like inheritance.
产业的概念就是要让它繁荣昌盛的。
The inheritance we want them to be prosperous.
你希望好好管理它，善用它，使它后来更多嘛
？You want your inheritance to grow by good management.
所以 Star Trek 里面有个祝福叫做 live long and prosper, right?
Yeah, in a Star Trek, you have blessing, living long and prosperous.
Oh, brothers, live long and prosperous.
Yeah.
那你知道，有些有钱人很讨人厌。
So you know that some rich person, they really, you cannot really like them.
不是因为他们很有钱，是因为他们没有好好管理他们的产业。
Not because they are rich, but because they didn't manage what they had.
如果他们把产业管理得很好，造福了很多人有工作，他们的生活很健康，你会觉得这么多产业交在这个人手里很好。
If those wise rich men they can manage their properties wisely to provide job opportunities to help others, you would think that oh they are good, they're good, they manage their properties very well.
你会瞧不起的是那种。根本不会管理产业，就有一大堆资源放在他手里的人，特别讨厌他。
You really look down those, despise those people, you know, who really didn't know how to manage their property, yet a lot of, they have a lot of things on their hands.
反过来，你手上资源很少，但是你能把这一点点资源管理得很好，有钱人看到你也尊敬你。
On the other hand, if you just have a little bit of the properties, but you manage those well, and the even rich men respect you.
所以说智慧与产业并好的时候，你得到了智慧就是要成为更有智慧的人。
So in this parable, the wisdom is like the inheritance. It's like if you are a wise man, you can be more, you can be wiser, you can have more wisdom.
所以说见天日的人得智慧更有益，我的理解是这样的。
So this is why it says the,You know, it is better to receive the wisdom for those who see the sun.
他说 ，see the sun， 见天日，我的意思是说，他对于长期来讲是乐观的，他认为是可以 prosper 的，是可以繁荣的。可是眼前呢，有很多的问题，他就常常愁苦。但是他对于长期来讲，基本上是乐观的。
So he is very optimistic for the future.Although he is facing some problems, so he's sad, but he believes that the future is brighter.
你知道一个牧师到一个地方去执一个教会，在那边奋斗了十五年。
You know, a pastor they went to a place to plant a church. He worked 15 years there.
十五年，每一年遇到问题都比前一年更困难。
He faced more difficulties year by year.
但是他心里面觉得这个地方需要一个荣耀的教会，他看到将来有个荣耀的教会，他对于未来整体来说是乐观的。
Yet he believed that this place need a church, so he is optimistic about the future.
就像你带领的儿女一样，他们很多问题啊。
It's like your children, they have many problems.
但是你心里面整体来说，你觉得他们是乐观的，然后你天天跟他们磨，有没有？
But you still have hope in them, right? You know that their brave, future is brighter, so that's why you deal with these problems every day.
得智慧的人就是希望繁荣，这不是成功神学，这是对上帝的主权有一种确信。
For those wise men who want to be a prosperous is based on the faith in the Lord.
现在所谓美国有股神巴菲特哈，其实他的投资就是投资在美国本身。
So we know this Buffett, the kind of the hero in the stock market. He just invested in the American.
他所谓的成功是对美国整体的发展是有信心的，所以投资在基础的产业上。所以他不投资在三年五年，他投资在十、十五、二十年。
He invested on long term because he believed that the future of the United States is better.
我告诉你，我现在也投资在中国。
I know, I'm telling you, I'm investing in China.
我对中国长期整体是乐观的。
I'm very optimistic about the long term in China.
我用我整个 career 去照顾中国的留学生。
I spend all my career to take care of those Chinese students.
我把我的才情投资在中国未来的知识分子身上。
I devote my career, my talent to those young generation in China.
你不要误会，我在中国没有房子。
I don't have any house in China.
因为我看好中国未来的社会、文化、经济、政治可能会有很大的变动。
I can see that probably in the future there will be big change in the China, in the politics and the economics and the social structure.
大家都在一片掌声叫好的时候，我觉得中国危机重重。
When I can see the crisis in China, when everybody is applauding.
可是我回头看中国现代化的历史，哈，中国最厉害的，中国的成长的动力在哪里呢？
But when I look back into the development of China, what is the driving force of the development?
我有一次去 Cornell University 拜访一个国际经济系的教授。
One day I visited a professor in the international economy in Cornell University.
他的研究是专门帮美国的大企业，哈，用中国帮他们把脉相命的，就是看这些外面看到资讯，然后想要去 gauge what's inside， 这是他的研究。
So we studied the basically the American what economy?
Yeah, economy at big companies.
Oh, big companies.
They want to see the realistic forecast of Chinese economy.
So Tom, yeah.
Yeah. 然后他就告诉我说哈。
So he told me that.
美国经济学对于国家经济发展的好几个模型、好几个 model 用来 apply 在中国经济都不正确。
So there are many models used to work in American economy are not right for Chinese economy.
所以他说美国学者非常的 puzzle， 非常的困扰，中国到底怎么克服这些困难站起来的呢？
So it is very puzzling for those scholars in the United States.How come the China can develop so fast?
好几次美国经济学家觉得中国要下来了，结果他又上去了。
Many times they think that okay, the China economy gonna fall apart, but somehow they survive.
后来他们得到了一个结论。
Finally, they came to a conclusion.
他说中国的成长只有一个条件。
There's only one situation that helped the growth of China.
叫做广大人民顽强的生存斗志。
It's just the strong will of the people.
他们就是 find out a way.
Yeah, they are, we Chinese find the way out.
我对于中国年轻人是有信心的。
I really have faith in the young generation of in China.
但是我认为中国独生代的青年，他们到他们要做领袖的时候，要处理很多很多棘手的问题。
But those youngsters who born in the 90s, 20s,When they took the leadership, they have to deal a lot of problems.
我鼓励我们的年轻人投资在自己的信仰、自己的知识、自己的品格和智慧上面。
I encourage our young generation to invest on their faith, on their wisdom.
他们有品格的话，这个世界可以信任他们。
If they have the good character, the world can believe in them.
他们有见识的话，他们可以处理复杂的事情。
If they have the foresight, they can handle bad, complicated situations.
他们有智慧的话，中国社会不论如何改变，他们都可以处理。
With their wisdom, no matter how the society changes, they can deal with that.
当然，最重要，他们要有信仰。
But most of all, they have to have faith.
他们明白众人的终局乃是面对神永恒的审判。
They need to realize that the end destiny of everybody is facing the judgment of God.
他们会珍惜他们有限的年日，将神所托付给他们的产业管理好。
They have the wisdom to manage the properties that God has given them wisely.
最后十三节说：“你要查看神的作为，因为神使为曲的，谁能变为直呢？”
In the verse 13, consider what God has done. Who can strengthen what He has made crooked?
这句经文其实是个谜语。
This is a puzzle.
因为正常的说法应该是，因为神使为直的，谁能变为曲呢？
Because the ordinary expression is that who can crooked what God has strengthened?
应该是这个世界上有很多的错误，但是如果神把错误矫正的话，谁能够扳倒上帝的真理呢？
It means that there are many, many wrong things in the world, but when God corrected them, who can damage God's truth?
但是这句话说，神使为曲的，谁能变为直的呢？
But this verse said, who can strengthen what he has made crooked?
他的意思是说，整个世界都完全在上帝的主权之下被管理了。
And it means that all the world is under the God's sovereignty.
包含那些错误的事情、弯曲的事情、悖谬的事情、腐败的事情，没有一件事情脱离上帝的主权。
For those crooked things, corrupt things, bad things, they are still under God's sovereignty.
所以你要查看神的作为，因为神已经为众人量定了结局。
If you consider what God has done, God already put the destiny for everybody.
神所命定允许的世间的一切的错误，在上帝面前是完全被他保守的。
God keep those bad things, although they look the bad, but God allowed them to happen.
意思是说即便这个世界上有很多的错误，但是这个世界是上帝在掌管的，这个真理永远不会改变。
It means that although there are bad things in this world, but this world is still under the sovereignty of God. This nobody can change this truth.
但愚昧的人看不见这一点，只会看见这世界充满了错误。
But the fools cannot see those; they just see the wrong things in this world.
但智慧的人会劝诫另外一个智慧的年轻人说：“你要查看神的作为。”
But a wise man will advise the other wise young man just consider what God has done.
在这个世界的许多错误的背后，有上帝隐秘的作为。
Behind all the wrong things, bad things in this world.There is a mystery deed from God.
所以在疫情中，让我们的心不要恼怒，不要惊慌。
So we wouldn't be angry or feared in this pandemic.
在疫情之后，让我们不要迷茫，不要失措。
Or we wouldn't get lost post-pandemic.
在疫情中，疫情之后的智慧是让我们看见神在历史中完全的掌权。
The wisdom after the pandemic is.That God is in sovereignty through the history.
神为我们量定了合适的位置，身边有很多的问题要处理。
God put us in the right position, although we have many problems to deal with.
耐心地去负起责任，研究问题。
Take your responsibility and deal with these problems patiently.
忧愁有时，喜笑有时。
It's time to be sorrow and it's time to laugh.
所以潘霍华在。所有美善力量这首歌里面这样写
So we just sing the song Gentle Power, it says
我用他的歌词来作为今天信息的结尾
I will complete this message using his word, word
他说所有美善力量都默默围绕奇妙地安慰保守每一天
It says all the gentle powers are surrounding us and keep us every day
让我与你们走过这些日子，并与你们踏入新的一年。
Let me go through these days with you and step into the new year with you.
所有美善力量都奇妙遮盖，不论如何都期盼那安慰。
All the gentle powers covers amazingly. No matter what, just looking forward the comfort.
在晚上、早上每个新的一天，上帝都将与我们同在。
God is with us every day, morning and evening.
我们一起做一个祷告。
Let's pray.
阿爸，我们的天父，我们赞美你。
Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you. We praise you.
在一切苦难与罪恶的背后，你仍然完全的掌权。
You are in complete sovereignty behind all the suffering and the wrong things.
你保守那认识你、敬畏你的人心里得着智慧。
You help those wise men who fear you, who worship you, to have wisdom in their hearts.
在这个世界欢乐的时候，我们忧愁；在这个世界哭嚎的时候，我们喜乐。
We mourn when the whole world rejoices, and we rejoice when the whole world mourning.
在这个世界用勒索和贿赂迷惑愚惑人心的时候，你赐给我们忍耐与安慰。
You give us endurance and comfort when extortion and pride corrupt and confused everybody.
使我们纪念死是众人的结局，我们都要向你交账。
So we can remember that the death is the destiny of every man, and then we have to face the judgment from you.
使我们用清洁的良心活在你面前，慎重地管理你所赐给我们的产业。
So that we can live in front of you with a pure heart and diligently manage what you have given us.
我们深信在这一切坏事之后，你仍会使我们繁荣昌盛。
We believe that you will make us prosperous after all these bad things.
你已经为你的百姓预备了美好的产业。
You have prepared a beautiful inheritance for your people.
坚固我们的心，让我们在每一天寻求你，依靠你。
Strengthen our hearts so that we can seek you, we can rely on you every day.
深知你仍然与我们同在，我们就在此得到完全的安慰。
Knowing that you are with us, so we can comfort in here.
我们这样祷告，是奉你儿子耶稣基督的名。
We pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.